one of the voices of the people protecting your pocketbook and calling out corruption is my friend Senator Ray Lesniak. Ray, good morning and welcome back to New Jersey 101.5. How are you?
Well, good morning. Unfortunately, every time I'm on the show, I have to talk about something bad that's going on in the legislature, and this is terrible.
This is awful, Ray.
It's a head scratcher. I don't believe how any legislator can think that this deal is going to be accepted by the public. It's outrageous.
I know. Let me ask you, do we know firsthand that the governor's pushing for this? Because it was one thing to say, hey, let me write a book and let me profit from it, and we could have that discussion independently. I can see your point where it's not right. But then you tie it in with gifts to the legislators to, right, you know, make it palatable, and it's another backroom deal. I'll give you this, you give me that.
Well, exactly. And whether it's the parole board, trading off people for outrageous salaries, they're not qualified, Port Authority commissioners who look the other way, this is a big problem in government. Democrats and Republicans working together to screw the public.
Yeah.
That's terrible.
So what do we do about it?
It's gotten worse. It's gotten worse than I've ever seen. And
what do you think it is, Ray? Have they just basically just have contempt for the voters and the people, and they say, come on. I mean, we were real close on question two, and I think that, if anything, should have shown them a message and you know, seen the light to say, wow, when the people get mad enough, you can almost move a mountain. We didn't have enough time.
Well, you know what? It really boils down to the same thing that happens in Congress, where redistricting makes districts where you can't lose. I can't lose in my district. You know, it's 80% Democratic.
Yeah.
I could lose in a primary, but, not in a general election. I think that's the biggest problem, because it doesn't matter what most legislators do, they're going to get reelected anyway.
Yeah.
So that's a systematic problem that I think only the Supreme Court can solve to stop us from doing that, because everybody's got to protect their own interests. That's how it works.
So how do we stop this deal? Because my head is having a hard time wrapping around the fact. And I went through a journey on this one, Ray. I got to be honest. Like, I started this morning thinking, does it really matter? Am I going to be that passionate about it? But then when you put it in context that the governor is trying to negotiate a personal payday and give away taxpayer dollars for increased legislative staff, my head almost exploded.
Well, and also, every other governor has been subject to this rule, Democrat and Republican. Governor Christie is not above the law, although he's trying to make himself above the law, and he's getting help from some Democrats for sure.
Who should we be talking to? Who do you think needs to hear from us? I mean, what are the prospects of defeating this if it comes to a vote?
I think the prospects are good. I mean, once we sound a clarion call, this is a lot more, I believe, outrageous than question two, and we came very close to defeating that.
Yeah, we did. We did.
So if just your listeners call their legislators and complain about it, I think that'll do the job for sure.
I love it.